city, you're a virgin. And Jesus can't save you, life starts when the church in. Jesus can't save you, Jesus can't save you, Jesus can't save you, Jesus can't save you. Jesus can't save you, life starts when the church in. Jesus can't save you, Jesus can't save you, Jesus can't save you.
That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture saith, Whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. For there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven. But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven.
Jesus can't save you, Jesus can't save you, Jesus can't save you.
One of the reasons why that we're building this holy hip hop church is, number one, is first off is that we want to expose every fruitless deed of darkness and to let kids know to have nothing to do with that. Understand is that when you are a friend of the world, you make yourself an enemy to God. And this holy hip hop church environment, what it will do is that it will give kids a clear conscience of just coming into the knowing of who Christ Jesus, setting them into an environment to where that they can understand who God is on their level. Not really trying to preach at them, or not really trying to quote a bunch of verses at them, but to let them know that your environment can impact you a whole lot where you're at today. Because I know for myself that one of the reasons why that I chose the route that I chose at a young age is because of what I was exposed to. Only thing I knew was secular rap. Those were the rhymes that I could quote. Those were the sayings that I had known. But this gospel rap, holy hip hop church, will give kids a different environment, exposure, hope. It will give them peace. It will a love that is a extension of Christ's arms, wanting to love them back, because knowing that he is the one that loved them first. Rap is needed to speak out to the secular rap, which is, you know, so interesting, because secular rap means those that are not a part of the clergy. And it's funny how when you break that word down, clergy means priesthood. So really, it's like they're not even a part of the royal priesthood which Christ offers. And so gospel rap comes to expose and to clarify that secular rap is an antichrist, a systematic system that wants to poison your mind, your thoughts, and your body and get you as far as away from God as possible. And so what we do as the gospel rap ministers is we want to expose that darkness and tell these kids that you have been called into God's glorious light. He died for you, buried on a cross, you know. And it's so funny, because in most environments you become what you hear. And so you know any urban city environment, hood, they have become what they heard. And you know, and so many of them are hearing, you know, this antichrist system of fornication, drugs, you know, pimp, you know, prostitute, you know, hate this guy, shoot this dude, jack this guy. And it's like, no, man, you're called for so much more than that. So that's why we do gospel rap.
My first name is Danielle Rollins Kendall, also known as Excite What. 34 years old, married, got one daughter, and it's so good, because I grew up right where we want to start the foundation of this holy hip-hop church at, which is right in Del Paso Heights. I grew up right here, born and raised. I got tons of family out here. And I grew up as a young, you know, man, and just in search of love, because my dad was gone and he couldn't love me. And just through, you know, trials and tests and, man, and just after 1 year in 2005 of just coming into the knowledge and the grace of Christ and who he is and how God is a father to the fatherless, touched me and just wants to use everybody in this ministry dream that we have to just come in these streets of Del Paso Heights and just reach the lost and the hurting.
Well, we actually met in high school, but he went off to college. So in 2004, I was in a car accident, and a week before my car accident, I was actually looking for him, but I wasn't able to find him. So I thought it wasn't the Lord's will for us to meet again. And then I called into the insurance company of the man who hit me in the accident, and he answered the phone. So I thought, wow, it was a God thing. So we went out to lunch, we started talking as friends, and 5 months later, we got married.
Here's your wife's version. Let's hear yours.
2004, I met my wife. She called into my job when I was working at State Farm Insurance as a claim rep, and was all frantic. What's my claim number? No, I'm just joking. No, she was calm and stuff. And, you know, my wife had this unique last name, which in high school I never could forget about it. I thought it was just, you know, unique. And so, you know, she calls in and she goes, "Hi, you know, I'm Richard Giannone, you know, my claim number, da 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 da." And I'm like, "Is this Rachel Giannone from Foothill High School, 1995? She's like, "Yeah." I'm like, "What? Are you still with, you know, so-and-so, you know, Mary Kid?" She's like, "No, I'm not." I was like, "What? I can't believe you're not still with that guy." And so, you know, me and her, you know, we started talking, went to lunch, you know, and just everything matched up perfectly. And then five months later, I was on one knee, you know, and she said, "I do," and I said, "I do."
24 years old. My name is Todd William Baumgartner. I'm from Davis, California. Right now is where I reside. I do everything in Sacramento, work, ministry. I'm also in Fairfield, but I'm saved. I'm a born-again believer. I believe in Jesus Christ. I believe in all 66 books. I'm a sold-out believer. I believe that my mission is to preach the gospel to all those who would hear. And I also am a part of Street Ministries. I'm a gospel rapper. I do gospel rap ministry. I also like to preach sermons. You know, my focus is completely orientated on heavenly things. I'm a born-again believer, so I don't live for myself. I live for Jesus Christ, and that's who I am. I'm a born-again believer. I'm found in Christ.
1 John 5:4. For whatever is born of God and is victorious over the world, this is the victory that conquers the world, even our faith. We need to celebrate in the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. The missile. Lil PK, who I'm seeing through God's eyes. Celebrate.
This is the reason why we lift them high.
Celebrate.
This is the reason why we lift them high.
Lift up his name.
This is the reason why we lift them high.
Celebrate.
This is the reason why we lift them high.
Lift up his name.
Jesus is worthy. Lift your hands in the sky.
Lift them up.
Jesus is worthy. Lift your hands in the sky.
Lift up his name.
Jesus is worthy. Lift your hands in the sky.
Lift them up.
Jesus is worthy. Lift your hands in the sky.
This is the reason why we lift them high. Jesus is worthy. Put your hands in the sky. I'm out of this world, so I'm living like a Martian.
Like
and Christ made me whole, so I'm full like a portion.
Like a portion.
Yeah. And we ain't dead like no corpses.
Like
alive, no extortion beyond all proportions. Philippians 4:4. Rejoice in the Lord and lift his name high for the price that he forfeited. It was his natural birthright to be King of Kings and Lord of Lords and make the earth right to crush sin and put the devil in his place. So when we bless him, Jesus showers down his grace. He died on the cross and he said the sin was finished. But he rise for the lost to repent and get with it. Start living your life for Yeshua. Start serving your master Yahweh. Start serving the kingdom. Yes, you are a child of God. Always.
This is the reason why we lift them high.
Celebrate.
This is the reason why we lift them high.
Well, my name is Anthony Ryan Trayvon Johnson. That's myself, my dad, and my brother's names all put together. So, I'm 16 years old. I first started rapping when I was 11. I used to write poetry back when I was like 9, write a little something-something, saying, "Mama, I love you so much, I love you a bunch," you know, silly stuff like that. Like I said, when I met Danielle, he had me write my first rap, and we didn't have a name. It just said Ant on the front, like a little bug, you know? And let's see, how I got my name. I think people just started calling me the preaching kid because Danielle, Excite, he would take me out whenever he would go ministering. And I would start telling people about Christ on my own at the age of 12. Just walking out there, you know, telling people like it is, and they were really impressed. They were saying, man, look at this little preacher kid. So I just stuck with it. I'm a little PK, getting a little bigger now, but praise God, I graduated.
Take her out, cause she's so bad. Down on my knees and ask my Lord to keep me clear from the devil, cause my girl, she's on fire. Yeah, and everything's so cool. She hot as hell, let's call her Helen. Fireman to her rescue like 9/11. And right, I think I hot, she got the cops. I do whatever with her. Hell's angel.
Why gospel rap? Gospel rap to me is a lot more than music. I choose gospel rap because God has equipped me with the talent of singing and rapping. But now God is using it. I can't say that I am, but God is using it for His glory. So gospel rap to me is the gospel message: Jesus Christ crucified, buried, rose again, and all 66 books, because He is the Word of God, and equipping that and turning it into a message through rap music or through singing, sharing testimony, also giving glory to God by bringing Him worship. So that's why I choose gospel rap music.
I do gospel rap because I feel that it is a very effective way to reach the lost. It's not necessarily, you know, rap itself. It's actually worship on a beat. We worship the Lord, we reach the lost, we minister, we do everything we possibly can through the music so that when they listen, they get touched by the Spirit of God.
Because the gospel has to be brought in the form of to where that we can contend with the secular artists. And the thing is about a gospel rap is it's the good news music. It's the things that kids need to hear about, just about the goodness of God and how He has came in the form of man to save man and to put man back in the right standing with Him. The message has not changed, it's just brought over a lyrical content that kids with the hip-hop mind or the secular world mind can hear the good news in a way that can touch their heart and so that God's word can effectively reach them in a way than just straightforward preaching at them from the pulpit. That's why gospel rap.
Is he wondering where I've been? So lost in
is deadly sin. Sometimes we hide, things behind our lives, but that pain we can't hide. No, no, still the pain will reside. Till we let it go, go, go. Gotta get in my soul so I can survive. All the pain will reside in dark.
Pain will
reside. Jesus be the light. Say
Jesus
yes.
Be the light.
Jesus in the fight. Come and
Jesus in the fight.
Oh, I pray to my Father.
Dear God, look.
Well, I started when I met Excite Bike, Danielle Rollins Kendall. He became my roommate, and long story short, he asked me to help him write a song, and I was like, okay, here you go. I wrote the lyrics out because he knew that I liked writing poetry, and eventually he told me that it was my voice who was going to be on the beat, and so that was my first song, and it's called My King. So I mean, y'all can look that up, and yeah, man, ever since that day, I was in the studio and I just realized, you know, this is where it's at. This is where Christ wants me to be. I can't just be going to church on Sunday and then cussing at school on Monday, bringing knives, getting in fights. I can't be doing that no more. I gotta live for Christ. I gotta represent it in the music. I gotta let people know and have them follow up. Just give their lives to Christ like I did. If I can do it, you can do it.
Started in gospel rap in 2006. I was actually in between writing worldly music and writing a little bit about Jesus Christ and a little bit about God. I didn't really even, it was completely unbiblical, unscriptural, the things I was writing, but like anybody who comes to Christ, they have to forsake everything and turn and completely leave their old life and come to Christ and lay down their life. And that's how it happened in my music. I met Danielle Rollins Kendall, the founder of Street Ministries, my close brother in Christ, and we were working together at the time at a dealership in Roseville, and he asked me if I liked Christian rap music, and I told him I did, and he gave me a CD, and I listened to it, and I was like, man, this brother goes really hard for the Lord, and it was gospel rap, and so I kind of, and he actually really followed up with me a lot, and really was trying to drive me to get involved, and you know, I really started to forsake all the worldly music I was doing, and I started truly writing for Jesus, and I started writing with the scriptural verses in my music, and in 2006 is when I came fully to gospel rap music and started writing for the Lord. So that would be almost 5 years from now.
Oh man, I started, man, back in 2005, man. I came to know Christ, and this brother by the name of Jesse had like all these beats, and one day he just gave them to me and was like, hey man, use these beats. And I was like, for what? And he's like, gospel rap. I'm like, gospel rap? Well, what's gospel rap? And he's like, it's just music about the good news of what Christ has done through you and just what his word says. And I'm like, man, that's hard. So I went home, man, and I was reading the Bible, and I'm like, how can I get these verses into words, into a style to where they rhyme and they make sense and are talking about Jesus Christ? So after 1 week of just praying, man, God just opened up the door and made my first album, Revelations 12:11. Oh man, and it was just basically the whole vision on that album was, you know, it was just talking about how we overcome through the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony, you know, and it was powerful because knowing God, I was able to use just of all them years of just living in sin that was just, you know, constant sin for like 28 years, and just use every test and every trial and every tribulation into seeing how God was really the mastermind all behind of me coming into knowing his son, Christ Jesus.
Monday, June 1st of 2009, President Barack Obama made an official proclamation declaring June to be the National Lesbian, Gay, Bisexual, and Transgender Pride Month, or LGBT for short. Obama proclaimed that he was proud to be the first president to appoint openly LGBT candidates to Senate-confirmed positions in the first 100 days of an administration. And then, to further solidify his stance as a champion for homosexual rights, he addressed the attendees at this year's 13th annual Human Rights Convention dinner on October 10th and made these disturbing statements.
You will see a time in which we as a nation finally recognize relationships between two men or two women as just as real and admirable as relationships between a man and a woman. That's why I support ensuring that committed gay couples have the same rights and responsibilities afforded to any married couple in this country. I believe strongly in stopping laws designed to take rights away and passing laws that extend equal rights to gay couples. I've required all agencies in the federal government to extend as many federal benefits as possible to LGBT families as the current law allows, and I've called on Congress to repeal the so-called Defense of Marriage Act and to pass the Domestic Partners Benefit and Obligations Act.
In the book of Genesis, chapter 1 and verse 27, the Bible says, "So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them." In Satan's attempt to confuse the natural order of sexual orientation that God created man with, he is subtly trying to carry out his sinister plot of destroying the image of God. And every organization and every celebrity and every individual that supports them are also uniting with the devil in carrying out his work to fight against God and to destroy his image.
Man, it's gonna take the church, the body of Christ, serving. We have got to serve. We've done so much of telling people who God is, and now it's time for us to show them who God is, which is God is a serving God of love and compassion, and a God that wants to see everybody come into the eternal glorious light of who he is today. And so we're gonna reach these youth by steady just knowing that God has called us to be an instrument of war and praise, and to let these people know that God loves them and God has called them to be like his son Christ Jesus. And it's gonna take, you know, work. And that's the way that you spell a revival. W-O-R-K, as our pastor John would say, you know, if you truly want revival, then, you know, work. You know, it's gonna take countless hours of time, and you know, into pouring out into this vision. And this is one of the brothers that I grew up with, and he knew me when I was a heathen of most heathens and sinning, and had a new girl in the barbershop every other Friday. And praise God, now they used to see me, you know, in a different light, and you know light, and you know, and this is one of the beauties of a homecoming, is that you get to see brothers that knew you when you was a sinner going, man, something has changed in you, brother, what you doing?
And I haven't seen this brother in 8, 9, almost 10 years. It's my first time seeing him in 10 years. Just seen his face, and I ain't seen him in 10 years, and I recognize this brother. If he was standing 2-3 miles apart, I know this brother, he a good man, and I'm glad he changed his life. I seen him when he was in the streets. Now I see him with the Lord. Now he chose the right path. He with the Lord. Now he's on the right path. He with the only path.
Amen.
Lord's path. That's the path you need to stay on. And someday, you know, he will reach out to these young folks. They will listen. Because he got my attention. I just turned 40. And I need to find God again. So I feel where he's coming from, and I hope he do reach out to the young folks around here, because they need God. Honestly, they do need God.
Honestly, I don't think it would take much, because I know I was really young, but I know that we all have the same concept. Who am I? What am I doing here? What's my purpose? And that's exactly what the Gospel Rap Church is here to do. You know, we spit that lyric out, and they hear it and they get drawn in, and then they actually listen to the words, not the beats anymore. It's the words that they hear that we're glorifying God with our lives. And that's that void in our lives that everybody wants. They want to be loved. They want something to love that they know would never betray them. And what it would take to reach the youth is prayer and effort. And that's it. It's prayer and effort. Everybody wants to be loved. Everybody needs to be loved. And the only person who can give us that love is God.
Well, I know that we are living in perilous times. I know that we are living in the last days. I know that there's a lot of promiscuity and wickedness, and it's abounding everywhere. But I really don't think the gospel changes. God's word doesn't change. It stays the same. The effectiveness of God's word does not change. It's powerful. Just as when the first church arose in Jesus' time, we're still in that church. And so I believe for us to reach the youth, we have to continue to preach the gospel message, the truth of God's word, not a watered-down, sugar-coated gospel. It has to be the truth, because only the truth can set these kids free. And most importantly, we gotta love them. We have to show them love. We can't just tell them about God's word. We can't just tell them about God's love. We have to show it. And the greatest amongst you will be your servant. So I believe that what it's going to take is that we serve these kids in their needs. You know, a lot of these people, these kids, especially in Del Paso Heights and throughout everywhere, they don't have good homes. They don't have good homes to go to. They have parents that are not really parents, more like friends. And so we want to love them and show them. And if they're not going to have parents, they're going to raise them up in the Lord. We're going to try to fulfill that as much as we can to outreach them. And that's what it's going to take. It's going to take the truth of God's word. It's going to take love and servanthood. That's what's really going to change the youth.
And yeah, I believe that God is moving through holy hip hop. I mean, men's lives have been changed. I know my life has been changed through it. I had a goal, and the goal was to fornicate for the rest of my life. But God came in and touched me and said, no, turn around, homie. Repentance. You know, and now through, you know, this music of holy hip hop, people are being reached. You know, people are learning scriptures, learning who God is, that He is holy, He's set apart from the world, He has nothing to do with sin, and that God loves all, and He came and He died for all.
Well, and I think too that, like I said before, that the music is just a tool. And the biggest thing that youth have of influence is music. They're influenced by, of course, the artist and what they're talking about, but in reference to their lifestyle, what they're going to practice, the way that they speak. So I think that the first thing, by getting the youth to listen to the gospel rap, they'll realize, wow, I'm hearing something different. And these men of God are still living a good life, that I can still do something different. I don't have to just be a product of my environment. I can choose something else. That's where the men of God in the church have to be strong men and know their word and be able to expose what they've been listening to.
B-I-B-L-E, spit. Living for the King and we don't quit. You could sit down in the pews and preach, or you could hit the streets and feed the lost sheep. Raise up a disciple, teach him how to live his life. We ain't doing wrong, but we trying to live light. Keep our game tight, yeah, we get the brothers right. Get them in the pews so we can preach and they don't lose. They got Christ on the feet and on the shoes. The gospel of peace, y'all, to spread the gospel. Living this life and we not any longer hostile. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. No other found I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
We really, really change. No, we not the same. Obedient children, we escape flames. Evil desires, that got changed. Living in sin, that's the wrong game. We are called holy. Would you change your name? Cause Christ is holy. No more seeking fame. Please don't be ashamed if you don't make it, man. Christ on Calvary, would you take him? The blood that was shed was perfect, without blemish. Don't love the world or anything in it. If you do, you living real hectic. Come to the Christ, you gon' reject it. Living for yourself cause you to get ejected. Choose Christ and then you will be accepted. Really, really change. No, we not the same.
Now that you've got a chance just to see the difference of gospel rap versus secular rap, I really, really want to invite you into now knowing that if you have any secular rap, antichrist, a systematic system on your life, I really, really want to give you some steps that can help you begin the process of how to release these things off of your life. Number one is you must understand that all men and women have fallen short to God's glory, and they've sinned before a just and a holy God. Number two is that you must understand is that your salvation was planned, that God loved the world so much that he crushed his son for you because he loves you that much. Number three is that it is God's will that everybody who be saved. Those who call on the name of the Lord shall be saved today. Number four is you must understand is that there was nothing that you can do to save yourself except believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved and your whole household shall be saved. Number five is that you must understand is that to be saved, you must confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead. Your confessing with your mouth is made unto salvation, and the confessing with your heart, that's made unto righteousness. Number six is you must understand is that it is not by works that any man is saved, but it's only by grace that you are saved. Through works, lest any man should boast of his own works. Number seven is you must understand is that you must confess sin to God because he is faithful and just to cleanse you of all unrighteousness. Number eight is you must understand is that those that come to Jesus, he will not cast you out, but he will take you in with all of his love because his arms are eternal, everlasting, and he is the God of your refuge today. Number nine is you must understand is that those that are in Christ, you become a new creature. Old things are passed away and all things become new to you today if you just believe and just walk as he walked. Number 10 is you must understand is that the benefit of this privilege of coming into Christ is that he gives you power to become a son of God because you received him and because you believe on his name. Last one is how that you know that you are saved is because God's spirit will bear witness with your spirit that you are a child of God and that you are saved. I would just advise you just to know today something else too, is that 20% of kids are dying and choosing a sinful lifestyle, all because of secular rap. But God wishes that none would perish, but that all might be saved today. Would you be saved today? Would you step out of your comfort zone and search for God? In Jesus' name, I pray for you.